The Bob Barker has entered an ice field in pursuit of a Japanese harpoon ship, the Yushin Maru No. 1. If the Barker can keep the harpoon ship on the move, it will be nearly impossible for them to start whaling.
They're very smart little dudes. If they're unlucky, they gotta be survived just stepping through their hole.
Yeah.
I mean, they're definitely not ice class, so at some point they're gonna puncture their hole and the whole bloody thing is gonna go down.
But the Bob Barker isn't immune to the danger of the ice either. Despite their reinforced hull, the crew knows that just 2 weeks ago, 22 people died in these same waters when their ice-class ship sank after hitting a growler.
Now it's looking thicker up ahead, eh?
Yeah, we have to go through.
Let's drain her out now.
Just take it easy.
For the last couple of hours, we've just been following the Yushin, which is taking us into some extremely big ice. It's very dangerous because it can rip open the hull very easily.
Towards that iceberg on the horizon, is that clear?
That's as good as it looks at this stage.
Yeah, still some ice there.
Well, there's ice everywhere.
Just watch this one here, it seems pretty thick. Go on starboard side, we're taking him on the other side.
I'm glad we're in an ice-class ship.
Wow.
Talk to me, what are they doing?
Now only 7 miles wide.
Very good. The Yushin Maru going into the ice was yet another attempt to stay away from us as long as possible. But we were more than happy just to keep following them, killing time. Because every day we stopped them from killing whales, it's a day one.
Well, we could dance all night with these people.
Mm-hmm. It's gonna be a long night.
Any minute now, boys. It could be. Keep your eyes peeled, okay?
5 hours ago, the Bob Barker's crew spotted one of the whaling fleet's three harpoon ships. Knowing the rest of the fleet could be just over the horizon, the Kajira crew is now on high alert.
Yeah, now's the time to be extremely vigilant on the old radar, guys. Any trail, anything at all, investigate it fully. Oh, yeah?
And us having to do this.
Well, for the time being, we're the only ones doing it, so somebody's got to do it.
Shouldn't be doing it.
Knowing the whalers could be close, deckhands Kevin McGinty and Larry Routledge assemble a projectile launcher that they call the Spud Gun.
The first one is in the position of the Australian Federal Police.
We weren't allowed to lie to customs and say that we had anything on board, which we didn't. It was all in bits, and not one bit of it was a spud gun, but collectively it became a spud gun. Hopefully it's going to be a very effective one.
The spud gun is used to launch projectiles onto the decks of the whaling ships.
Should we try it with one?
The Sea Shepherds hope to gain as much range as possible with the new device.
Look at that sucker go!
Knowing the whalers are close by, Captain Paul Watson is desperate to find the rest of the fleet. But the helicopter is grounded because of snow. So the Steve Irwin's crew must search the hard way.
It looks like ice up there.
Yeah.
So we're gonna just keep this course all the way to the edge of the ice.
Yeah.
Right, let's do it.
What's going on with that?
Hey, what is that?
Has a speed of a half a knot.
What's that? Yeah. Can you see?
Can't see much.
They wait for a break in the fog, hoping to identify that the ship is part of the whaling fleet.
Yeah, 1.5 inch vessels.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
With the Bob Barker already chasing the Yushin Maru number one, the Sea Shepherds have now found two of the fleet's three harpoon ships.
We're in a position that we really haven't been in before. We found the fleet so early. We have an idea where the Yushin Maru is. You know, they're so close. It seems as if, like, you know, they're just over the horizon.
They are screwed.
Right now in the ship, there is like a really exciting vibe. Like everybody is just like filled with energy and adrenaline, and everybody is just running around and like asking and talking and getting really exciting. I think right now there is no other place on Earth that I would rather be than here, like fighting for this cause and just making a change in history for the planet.